Assalamu alaikum everyone, and may Allah bless you wherever you are, whenever you are, in your city, in your town, in your job, at work, doing shopping, whatever it is. I was praying Jum'ah in Al Amana Mosque in Birmingham City, and I was just coming from Kuwait via Istanbul. It was a journey more than 12 hours. I was very exhausted because it was an overnight journey. Exhausted, tired, and in a rush because I was supposed to be traveling to Aberdeen City at a flight at 3:45 to give condolence to my late Dr. Jamal, the father-in-law of my daughter. I went to the prayer hall, and the Khatib, may Allah bless his soul in this life and life to come, he was taking his time to finish the sermon after 2 o'clock, about 2:10 or 2:15, and I was rushing to go to meet my friend who was going to give me a lift to the airport. And even I did not want to greet many people, I just rush. We went to the car parking space, and as usual, the car parking space was full of cars and double parking or triple parking or quadruple parking, and none of these cars could move outside the gate of the car parking. And the Somali brother who was actually blocking the gate was sitting and not standing, talking to a colleague in a very comfortable, cool manner, not realizing how he is blocking the road in front of everybody and the cars for everybody. And soon he came to his car. I was, my nerves were boiling, and I went to him and telling him, do you think that Allah will accept your prayer by blocking those cars from not being able to move as quickly as possible? The man became furious, angry, and he called upon his fellow friend, who is the landlord of this car park, and he told him, please go and lock the gate of the car parking and go and get the police. And the landlord started to say a lot of things in Somali, and a lot of ayah and a lot of hadith, and people were shouting and surprised what's happening all of a sudden. Actually, some of the people could not be able to understand why all this argument is happening, and the rest was trying to cool him down. And I was shocked as well. But the conclusion is, he cooled down, he opened the gate, and we went rushing by the car to go to the airport to catch the 3:45 flight to Aberdeen. The lesson we learn from this is, be lenient, be kind, be cool, be patient, be showing perseverance as well. It was on me. It was my responsibility not to try to stir the problem with the Somali brother, was telling him, actually, do you think Allah will accept your prayer or not? It's not my business, as best of Allah. Second point, I was supposed to be more cool and quiet and patient with him because I'm the old one and could be more learned than him. Number three, I was supposed not to argue with him or not to argue with his friend. And the last but not least, and I was supposed to control my manners and control my behavior and show this, to compose myself. My apology to everyone who listened to this lesson, but actually, we should not behave as I did. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.